note that. And I want to make sure that our army remains the best army in Africa. So we are not letting it down. We are going to work much more and as hard as possible so that your successes are not again survived in these waves. So I thank you and allow me, therefore, to lead the speech of His Excellency the President, who has already called you and apologized that he could not make it, but he is with you in the heart of the speech. So when I read this message, of course, I will not say anything more. So the message goes on like this. His Excellency General Yoweri Kaguta Museveni, the President of the Republic of Uganda, it is congratulatory message from His Excellency General Yoweri Kaguta Museveni, President of the Republic of Uganda, Brigadier General Omori Bosco and Mrs. Omori upon your wedding, 13th November 2021. The parents, the bride and the groom, relatives, invited guests, ladies and gentlemen, I wish to congratulate today's groom and bride, Brigadier General Omori and Mrs. Omori, upon their wonderful decision to formally enter into the institution of marriage. Today, you have agreed to share in the joy and privilege of marriage, and as husband and wife. I thank you for making this commitment before God, before your parents, relatives, friends, and all the people here present. I pray that you find everlasting joy and fulfillment in your marriage. I want to thank the family of Brigadier General Omori for inviting me to share in the joy of witnessing your children enter into holy matrimony. This is a wonderful testimony to the proper efforts, to the proper maturing you have given your children. So the President is thanking the family and parents for being a general money. So your commendable efforts to instruct your children to follow the correct path in life have yielded tremendously. Today, your children, Gideadino, Omori, and Joseph, have given you honor and pride because you labored to instill into them the right values. Through your constant guidance and exemplary conduct, your pride as parents is watching your children make the right decision in life. I ask that you continue praying and guiding the younger couple and also make sure that they embark on the journey of their marriage ahead of them. I have known Brigadier General Omori from our Kronasa days. I know him as a dedicated and disciplined soldier. He is a freedom fighter who has his country at heart. To the bride and the groom, today you have become husband and wife, and you have all come here and witnesses to the eternal vows you have made before God. to love and cherish each other. Today marks a new chapter in your lives. To use the language of the Bible, Brigadier General Omollet has found his reed. The Bible tells us in Genesis chapter 2, verse 22, that the Lord God made a woman from the reed he had taken out of the man, and he brought her into the he brought her, and the God brought her to the man. Therefore, marriage is a sacrament. Therefore, marriage is a sacred institution ordained by God as a special gift, because it brings man and woman together in perfect unity to complement each other. So I pray you anchor your marriage on love, honesty, faithfulness, patience, prayer, good communication, and so on. These virtues will give your marriage a solid foundation, which will enable you to live a happy and fulfilled married life. Above all, I encourage you to make God a priority in your marriage. God is the author of your marriage. You must thus build your marriage on values and practices that reflect what God wants. This way, your marriage will prosper in every aspect. Finally, I once again want to congratulate you upon your glorious decision to commit, enter into holy matrimony, and I wish you a fruitful and happy marriage.